Now let's get some rapid-fire response from our panel on these stories tonight. Rand Paul is now avoiding the cameras. He just canceled on Meet the Press. Says he's too exhausted. The show's executive producer wants him to reconsider and keep his commitment. You know, in the 62-year history of this show, Meet the Press, only three major guests have ever canceled. The other two are Louis Farrakhan in 1996 and Saudi Arabia's Prince Bandar in 2003. Maybe he'll reconsider. We hope he does. Today, the Texas Board of Education voted for rewriting history to reflect Tea Party values. How exciting. Some of the proposed changes include Social Security is bad, McCarthy's communist witch hunt was good, and never forget that the president's middle name is Hussein. The House Armed Services slapped down the president's efforts to close Guantanamo Bay. They just passed a bill that would prohibit sending Gitmo detainees to a special prison in Illinois that only cost $350 million. With us tonight, Jack Rice, former CIA officer and criminal defense attorney, and also Heidi Harris, radio talk show host out of the great city of Las Vegas. Jack, start this off for us tonight. What do you make of Rand Paul? I said last night he's an unguided missile. He certainly is great copy for those of us in talk radio. But what do you make of this guy? Is he legitimate?
Oh, of course he's not legitimate. Actually, I think it's genius that he actually shut his mouth at this point. I mean, his PR guys are saying, for God's sake, please, just stop talking. I mean, the fact that he actually has to go down this path, I mean, we look at what he said about BP. He's basically come out now saying, I guess what's most important is that you protect corporations even over individuals. I guess that's what American is now? Really? I'm thrilled that people are stomping on this guy. I'm curious to see if Republicans are going to be willing to do the same thing rather than sort of cozy up to the Tea Party groups, because that's what they've done so far. We'll see.
Heidi, you got the floor. What about Rand Paul?
Well, I got to say, I understand what he's saying for the concept of federal government getting involved in business. You know, for example, here in Vegas a couple years ago, they passed an anti-smoking ordinance, which meant that if you owned a bar, you weren't allowed to have smokers in there, depending on how many slot machines you had. And I was opposed to that because it's government going after business. But by the same token, when it comes to race, I'm sorry, I can't get on that. You cannot tell people they can discriminate here in America. Because what if you're driving through a small southern town and it's all white and you're a black family and you break down, or you need gas or food, and no one will serve you? Can't have that in America. Sorry.
Heidi, what do you make of the vote in Texas where the Board of Education is going to now add the contributions of the Heritage Foundation, the National Rifle Association, and omitting the speech, one of the writings in that Birmingham jail by Martin Luther King? What's happening here?
Well, I think it's interesting because a lot of these books are very, very tilted to the left, as you well know. You may not think they're tilted to the left because you are, but the books are. And I think people on the right are saying, hey, let's just get a little more fairness. Let's get it a little more equitable. And let's talk about some things that have been purposely left out. I don't have a problem with it. I haven't seen one thing in there that I would consider outrageous. And, you know, why not? They have the right to do that if they choose to.
Okay, they have the right to do it, so we should rewrite history, and maybe we should just throw Martin Luther King out of the book altogether. Jack, what do you think?
I completely disagree with Heidi on this. I mean, the real problem is we're not seeing intellectual honesty here. Some of the things that are being said are flat-out false. The idea that you're going to question the sovereignty issue of the UN, that they're trying to take U.S. sovereignty, I mean, that's a perfect example. It's one of the things they're fighting for, and yet one of the P5, the United States, can veto anything that rolls through the United Nations. It's simply incorrect. It's factually wrong. We can disagree with subjective things, opinions, but you can't disagree about facts. But apparently, this school board thinks that you can.
Jack, what do you make of the House Armed
Services?
Go ahead.
Sorry. I was just going to say,
Heidi,
of course,
please.
The UN's out to destroy our sovereignty. Are you kidding? They're right about the UN. The UN's a terrible organization. Why don't they go somewhere else? And now, why are they here in America? Why are we paying their bills? They're out
Heidi,
to destroy America. They're
clear.
Anti-America.
But see, Heidi, here's the point, is that if you look at what the Security Council is, anything of significance at the United Nations happens in the Security Council. Anything that happens at the Security Council, the United States can veto by themselves and stop it. And so the ability for sovereignty from the United Nations is completely ridiculous because the UN can stop it unilaterally. Everybody knows that if you actually follow what they say, because the United States was fundamentally involved in setting it up.